Let's talk about how to use the pivot underscore wider function in the tidyr package to increase the number of columns in the data frame but reduce the number of rows. The main arguments of pivot underscore wider are data, which is the data frame that you want to pivot, the names underscore from argument, which is the column from which the names of the new columns is going to be taken, and values underscore from, which is the column that contains the values that the new columns are going to be created from. The previously mentioned table 2 is a nice data set to tidy using the pivot underscore wider function, so that's what we're going to do here. So I've printed that to the screen just so you can see it once again, and there's two issues with this data set. So one, we have the values for cases and population being in one column, and also the observations for a specific year are split across multiple rows. So we want to make this data set wider. Specifically, we essentially want to take, for example, this row right here and add it as another set of columns to our data frame. So we actually do want to reduce the number of rows in this data set while adding some columns. So we do want to make the data set wider. So in this particular case, we are going to pivot wider table 2. The names of the new columns that we want to create are going to come from the type column here, which has the names cases and population. And then the values for those two columns are going to come from the count column. So we're going to pivot table 2 wider, taking names from the type column, and then using the values from the count column to fill those new columns with data. And you can see that what we get is down below. And so we have made our data frame wider. The information for every country in a specific year is now in a single row. We don't have any variables in multiple columns. We don't have any observations across multiple rows. And the values for every variable are in their own cell. So we have now made this data set tidy. I do want to point out that we could have done this using the pipe operator if we had wanted to. We can pipe the table 2 data frame into the pivot underscore wider function. That's going to be the first argument of this function. And then we can take the names of the new columns we want to create from the type column of the original data frame, and the values we want to put in those columns from the count column of the original data frame. And it's going to produce identical results to before.